Hey guys, Mr. Shaw here reporting from Quito in Ecuador. As the name might let you know, the name of the country, Ecuador, is right on the equator. And that means that it gets basically the same amount of sun throughout the entire year because the sun hits it in the exact same place. And now it does kind of have the tilted axis of the earth to worry about, so there is still going to be a little bit of variation depending on where in the country you are. And of course, you've still got the day and night cycle, but the amount of time you have sunlight every day is going to be about the same. The angle of the sun is going to be about the same. So just think to yourself, like, how hot do you imagine it would be if you're in a country that's on the equator, gets a whole lot of heat from the sun every single day? It's actually only about 73 degrees here, and the low at night goes down to 45, even on the equator. It's cooler here in the summer than it is in Indianapolis. What I think is odd about that is because if you look around, you can see some trees that look like they're pine trees, some trees that look like they are tropical trees, and some trees that look like they are somewhere in between, that would lose their leaves. And that has to do with the altitude. See, Ecuador is almost over 9,000 feet above sea level. It's so high up that a lot of the air gets a little bit thinner. You usually have a little bit less pressure. It can be harder for certain kinds of plants and animals to even survive up here because of the lack of air and air density. But beyond that, it also gets a lot cooler as you go higher and higher up in altitude. There's just not really enough gravity to even hold in the level of atmosphere you would need to hold the heat from the sun's radiation. So a lot of it just doesn't really reach up here in the same kind of way, even if the sun is beating down on you. And that has to do with the level of the greenhouse effect that hits when the atmosphere is really thick. You have a lot of greenhouse gases really far down, closer to the sea level. It's going to reflect all the radiated heat from the sun. It'll bounce around, and then eventually it'll reflect out into space, but not before it heats everything up around down below. That's why in places like Death Valley in the United States, which are below sea level, it is absolutely scorching hot in that desert. Whereas in other places that could be the exact same latitude, if they're at a different altitude, they'll be at a different temperature. The tree behind me looks kind of like a palm tree if you just look at its trunk. It's actually a really unique tree, sometimes called the monkey puzzle tree, but here called the araucaria tree, that has evolved for this unique climate. If you look higher and higher and higher, you actually don't find the palm leaves you would find in a normal tropical climate. Instead, you find these coniferous leaves, because this is actually a coniferous tree, just like pine trees, fir trees, and birch trees. If you actually see the leaves, once you pluck them off, they look like this. They're scaly, and they're needly, and they actually hurt quite a bit. I kicked one earlier and almost cut myself. But these trees are really hard to find anywhere other than really high altitudes up here in South America. And they were called the monkey puzzle tree because they said a monkey would be too puzzled to really understand how to climb one, because it's so different from any other tree you could ever find. They are endangered here, but the bark is so thick that it's resistant to wildfires, even though the leaves can withstand cold temperatures, but also get enough sunlight, because they're so high up, to be able to photosynthesize even on the equator.